Yo, look, I'm sorry I stepped away from the Antarctica conspiracy theory series, but here we go, and it's a big one. We're gonna talk about the Hollow Earth, how the North and South Pole both have entrances to the Hollow Earth. Yeah, you heard me, and I got some satellite proof to back it up. Let's get it. Alright, so first we're gonna take a look at these ESSA satellite images. Alright, so y'all see how both ESSA-3 and ESSA-7 resemble the same thing, the North Pole and the hollow entrance within. It's insane. And on top of this, it's plenty of more satellite images. Then on top of that, in Antarctica, there's also a hole. The hole is the size of Kansas, and it keeps reopening and closing, reopening and closing. As far as from what I know holes in nature, especially when ice is involved, do not open and close. Again, at least from what I know. And again, this image was taken June 1970, not too far after Richard Byrd and Operation High Jump. Around this time, a lot of things dealing with the inner hollow earth were being exposed. Operation High Jump was a major, major leap as far as figuring out if the earth is actually hollow. According to Richard Byrd, I believe it. And the evidence behind it to the primary sources and documentaries, you have no choice. It's all in front of you. And the fact that no one is authorized to fly over the North and South Pole, it does all leave you to believe that there's more to the North and South Pole than we may think. Operation High Jump indeed told us that it's an ancient civilization living within the hollow earth. They're much more advanced as far as technology. With that being said, it does leave me to wonder, are we really the aliens? Y'all go ahead and let me know what y'all think in the comments. And spam up that pot 6. Let's get it.